Hello, I am Chris Menard. I have a great video. I'm going to use Power Query in Excel to take some email addresses in Outlook and break them out from with name and the actual email so each one is on a separate row in Excel. We'll use Power Query for this. Let's dive in right now. So go ahead and pull up Excel. Give yourself a blank file or a blank worksheet. Give yourself room to work. Pop over into Outlook. It doesn't matter whether it's your inbox or your sent. Click on an email. Do Control A, that is select all, followed by Control C, which is copy. After you do Control A and Control C, you are done with Outlook. Pop over into your Excel file. Over in Excel, go to cell A2 and Control V or paste in those emails. I just pasted them into cell A2 right there. Just so you know, for training purposes, I came up with fictitious email addresses. None of these are real. All the domains are fictitious and the names, my name is correct, but the other names are not. A1, the reason I did it in A2, A1 is going to be your header. Type in email, make it bold, perfect. We're going to use Power Query now. We need a table. If you've never used Power Query, give this a shot. It's going to be really simple. Data tab, from table range, create table, hit OK. Power Query will launch. Feel free to maximize it if you want to, which I did. Email is at the top. That's my header row, and then below it are all the email addresses. So here's some of the issues right here. Item number one. Everything's in this first row. I actually have three emails. So I'm going to click on email and go to transform. I could also do a right click to do this. I'm going to hit split column by delimiter. Really, really cool feature here in Power Query. What is the delimiter? Well, the delimiter is a semicolon. If you notice, there's a semicolon between the addresses. But here's where it gets cool. If I hit Advanced Options, I can tell Power Query, I don't want to split this in columns. I actually want to split this in rows. So make sure it's rows and hit OK. Watch this. I had three emails. There are my three emails sitting right there. Really cool feature there. So that was Transform Split Column. We're going to do another split column. And just to prove you can right-click, I'm going to right-click on Email. Right-click on email and go to split column by delimiter. But this time, your delimiter, if you look at the email addresses, take a look at mine. Chris@fictitiouscompany333. That email has the less than and greater than symbol around it. So I'm going to use the delimiter custom, and I've already came in here and did this. Put in that symbol right there, less than. Now go to Advanced Options. This time you do want columns. Click OK. Getting close. Now the emails are in a separate column by themselves. The issue is these email addresses look at the very end of them. We need to remove that. That is simply a replace. Right click. Replace values. Value defined. Greater than, replace with, leave it empty. Don't click in there and hit the space bar or anything. Just leave that replace with empty and hit OK. Watch over in email period two. Perfect. Your email addresses are correct. This one's done. The only thing you may want to do is change that title. I don't care for email.to. You can type in email address. You can put in whatever you want there. And then email one, this is the names. So I'm just renaming stuff. Name that name. One more item to fix, and it drives me nuts. There is a space between before Chris starts and before John starts. Christian is actually okay because he was the very first one in my email list. So now we need to also do the trim function. You can do it from right here. I'm going to right-click on name, transform, trim. Perfect. All the empty and extra spaces are removed. Everything is perfect here. You're ready to go. Go back to the word home, close and load to. Watch how cool this is. You will get a new worksheet. There is that new worksheet right there. So now you've got your names and your email addresses broken out. I'm not going to do it, but what's also cool is if I come back in here to sheet one and I get another email and do the control A, control C, and come over here and put it here, it will update my Power Query. My table gets updated, the Power Query gets updated, and those names would fill in over here automatically, and I can keep this list going. Really cool feature right there. Feel free to sign up for my Excel online training class. I also have Microsoft Teams online. If you like this video, hit the like and give me a subscribe. I appreciate your support. Have a great day.